virtually every townland in Ireland has a lot of history attached to it. Corran in particular, the era from 1798 up to the 1940s or 50s, taking in the Second World War. Here in Temahoa, if we start at the east end of the townland where Brady Meats factory is at the moment, people will be familiar with it. Directly across from the road from that was the site of the rebel camp in 1798. It was an important camp. It fed in the rebels into the Battle of Prosperous, which was a very successful battle for them. They'd done very well in it. They were able to travel across the bog from here through Ballinafah in where the British wouldn't know their way around, or with horses and that would be sinking and all that sort of stuff. It was a huge success, but of course the backlash was that a couple of days later they sent out a gang and burned the Staplesound Church. So I suppose there's always a payback. If we move up from there now a little bit along the road here, this spot was known as the Old Post Office at the end of a lane, and that lane is known here as the Street. It was the street of the old village of Temahoe back in the early days in the 1800s and into the early 1900s. It was home to about four shops, some houses, a graveyard, church ruins, and a forge up the road on one side and a pub down the other side, which was known for years to all of us as Bradys of Temahoe, and there was a grocery there. Now, tying up the graveyard to the 1798 scene, it's said locally here that a wounded rebel returning from Prosperous died in the graveyard and was buried there. I was never able to get the exact location or details, but there are headstones there from the late 1790s, and I'd be fairly sure that the story is right, that it did happen. And unfortunately for the man, he didn't make it to the camp with his wounds, and he was buried in the graveyard there. If we move up a bit up the road from there, we have a remaining Quaker house, Temahoe House. It's pretty much the same as it was in the Quaker days here. They had their own style of building with a room going from the front to the back and a window on each side, that type of thing. The Bennett family live there now. It's a good example of what the houses were at that time. A short distance further up from there, with the old school, which was in use up to 1886. Now, the building was a mud wall building, of course, and it wouldn't be in great shape. The teacher lived in it as well. There was a classroom and a teacher's room. Later, it became a medical centre, and later still, it became a residence and was rebuilt some years back. And that stands just short of the Quaker burial ground, which is further up on the right-hand side, a couple of hundred metres. The burial ground for us here, the most notable, was the visit of Richard Milhouse Nixon, here, the American president. His ancestors, the Milhouses, left here around 1802 or 1803 and went to the States. Their home was Bushfield House. It was located further up at the cross, at what we call Carter's Cross, and it's located behind where Francis Morne and Tommy Flaherty have their houses nowadays. The Quakers had a corn mill there at the crossroads as well. They were very enterprising people. They were self-sufficient. They didn't enjoy a lot of comfort here because some local people weren't in favour of them. They weren't employing anybody, so they weren't doing anything as in their view for the economy. Now, on the way up there, we passed the Quakers' graveyard, of course, where the meeting house was. It was burned down some many, many years back. We can return down the road then back to what was the village. We have the school built in 1886. It's a very modern school now, beside the pub, and it's next door to the Coolcarrigan estate owned by Robert Wilson Wright. This was bought back in the 1830s by Mr. Wilson from Belfast. There was intermarriage there. Wright, gentleman's son, died in the war, and his daughter married Wilson. So hence we had the Wilson Wright name on that. A fine place with beautiful gardens and all that, which are open during the year, but a lot of history attached to it, yet back to the War of Independence and so on. Further up again, with the junction to Staplesound, there's a two-story house on the left-hand side, which was once the North West Kildare Cooperative Society shop. It supplied all the heavier as well as the general farm supplies, and for a few years there was a library located upstairs in it. The dwelling in front of it became the focus of attention when three men on motorcycles were ambushed in error in 1921. They were actually taking messages to the IRA, who were billeted in Coolcarrigan. One man died at the scene, one man escaped unscathed, and the third man was taken to Nays Hospital under armed guard. Now, the amazing thing about this was, in the most daring procedure, he managed to escape. two nurses in the hospital who were looking after him approached the armed soldier in the ward and told them they had to do some procedures which would be very embarrassing for them if he was watching. So he agreed to go outside and in the corridor and have a smoke. And when gone, the patient was bundled out through a window to a waiting party and he was whisked away back to Tipperary to live in hiding. He later became a TD, I think a Labour Party TD for Tipperary. Just past the church in Coolira was the farm of J.P. Cusick. Joseph Cusick was a leader in the IRA Sinn Féin group and became a judge in the Sinn Féin court, organiser of the hostilities, or if you want to call them that, that were in this area at that time. Beside his house is the remains of the Bordnamona camp, offices and workshops developed in the 30s and 40s by the Turf Development Board. If we move up the road, we come to Kyledove Village, the townland of Blackwood, a very big townland. And Bordnamona, in 1952, they established a village there, purpose-built, four shops and 160 houses for the men who were working on the bog. Those guys all came up from south and west and southwest of Ireland, were single people. Obviously, they met local ladies and got married, so there's a requirement for houses. So that's how Bordnamona managed that. We call it Kyledove here. Some call it Kildove. It depends on what part of the country your Irish knowledge is from. Beautiful layout and all that, and it contained a site for a hall, a site for a school, and a site for a church. Now, the church afterward was built a bit down the road in Coolira. And incidentally, they're a pretty serious hurling club. They have achieved 11 County Kildare Senior Hurling Championships. Now, one would say that a lot of the blood around there would be from hurling counties like Limerick and Clare and Tipperary and Galway and so on. That's pretty well takes it up now to as far as the main road from Edenderry to Prosperous at Dagwell's Pub. It's where we start from there.